So now let me take up the next topic, that is gout. So now I'll be discussing the group of drugs which are used in the treatment of gout or gouty arthritis. Now, what exactly is the gout? Remember, gout is the disease which is characterized by elevated serum uric acid levels. Right? It is a disease which is characterized by elevated serum uric acid levels. Right? It is a disease which is characterized by increase in the serum uric acid levels. Now, where is this particular uric acid coming from? Remember, gout or gouty arthritis, it is the disorder of the purine metabolism. Alright? Now, if you take this particular uric acid levels, they are very much elevated in the gout or gouty arthritis. And you take this particular uric acid, it has a low water solubility. Alright, the uric acid, it has low water solubility. Now, because this particular uric acid, it has low water solubility, this particular uric acid, it gets precipitated within the joints. Right, uric acid, it is precipitated within the joints. Now, remember, it is not only precipitated in the joints. This uric acid, it is precipitated within the kidneys, and it is also precipitated within the subcutaneous tissue. And how is it precipitated in the joints, kidneys, or subcutaneous tissue? Remember, it is precipitated in the form of the crystals. Right? It is precipitated in the form of crystals within the joints, kidneys, or within the subcutaneous tissue. Right. Next. So, the uric acid levels increasing because of the purine metabolism, that is because of the disorder of the purine metabolism, is your gout or gouty arthritis. Now remember, we have another terminology which is called as secondary hyperuricemia. Right, another terminology which is called secondary hyperuricemia. Now, let me discuss what is this secondary hyperuricemia. This secondary hyperuricemia, it results due to either excessive production or decreased excretion. Right? It occurs due to excessive production, or it may occur due to decreased excretion of the uric acid. Right? Decreased excretion of the uric acid. That is called as secondary hyperuricemia. Now, in which all conditions there will be excessive production of the uric acid? Remember, wherever or in whichever clinical conditions where there is increased breakdown of proteins and nucleic acids. Now you see here, in which clinical condition where there is excessive breakdown of these particular proteins, remember those individuals who are taking cancer chemotherapy. Right? Those individuals who are taking this cancer chemotherapy. So in this group of individuals, there is increased breakdown of proteins and as well as nucleic acids, and that will result in increased production of the uric acid, which is called as secondary hyperuricemia. Now, in certain clinical conditions, there is decreased excretion of the uric acid. Now, in which clinical condition there is decreased excretion of the uric acid? Remember, due to the usage of certain diuretics, like for example, you take thiazide diuretics. When an individual is on thiazide diuretics, or when the individual is on loop diuretics, what will happen is, the loop diuretics and thiazide diuretics, they get secreted into the proximal convoluted tubule through a same transporter system at which the uric acid is also secreted. I'll repeat this. Thiazide diuretics and loop diuretics, they are secreted in the proximal convoluted tubule of the nephron, at the same point where the uric acid is secreted into the tubule and it gets excreted out. Now, because whenever we give thiazides and loops, they get secreted instead of uric acid at the level of the proximal convoluted tubule in the nephron, and thereby uric acid levels, they get increased in the kidney because of due to decreased excretion, right? Now, the other drugs which will decrease the excretion is, next we have an anti-tubercular drug that is ethambutol. So ethambutol will also decrease the excretion of this particular, the uric acid. And lastly, clofibrate, which is an anti-hyperlipidemic drug. Right? So the clofibrate, which is a drug which is used in dyslipidemia, they also will decrease the excretion of the uric acid. So secondary hyperuricemia, it might be due to increased production or decreased excretion. So due to increased production, where do we see? Wherever there is increased breakdown of proteins and nucleic acids due to cancer chemotherapy. And where do you have decreased excretion of the uric acid? Whenever the individual is on thiazide diuretics, when the individual is on loop diuretics, when the individual is on ethambutol or clofibrate, in such clinical condition, the individual will have this secondary hyperuricemia. So this is what is the basic pathogenesis happening within the gout. Now what will happen is, these particular crystals, they get deposited within the joints and the individual will have very severe pain because of the deposition of the crystals within the joint. Now what is the joint which is most commonly affected, or which is the joint which is first affected? Remember, the joint which is first affected is, it is first metatarso phalangeal joint. Right, it is first metatarso phalangeal joint. This is the first joint which is affected in these patients with the gout.